The another type of loop is for loop. Let us understand how does this loop work. As by now you know that loops are nothing but useful to execute block of statements again and again. But why do you need for loop? We mainly use for loop if we know that the block of statements are to be executed a particular number of time. Only then you use for loop. In case of for loop, what happens is that we need to understand about the three elements. So we write the syntax with for keyword, where f is in lowercase, then in the bracket, first you initialize the value. What is this initialization? In case of for loop, the variable that you initialize here is only once initialized. You cannot initialize it again and again. That is, you cannot change the value of that particular variable initialized. For an example, you have set the value here, a variable called int I is equal to so and so. So you will not be able to change the value of this variable. If I is equal to 1, therefore, until unless the codes run a particular of number of times, that will remain same until unless the value has been changed. The next one is Boolean expression. This Boolean expression is nothing but what condition is to be met. If a particular condition is true, then please execute a block of statements. And if the condition is not true, it will not go check for the update, neither it will execute the block of statement. What it will do is that it will come outside and start executing the rest of the statement outside the for loop. So what happens here is that once the condition is met true, it will come inside, execute the block of statements, and once it executes the block of statement, then it will go back to its update statement. What is this update? Update may be increment or decrement. As we said, we need to stop our loop after a certain number of time. So we need to increment the initialized value, right? So once the block of statement is met true, it will execute the block of statements, go to the update statement, and then again it will come inside, then execute the block of statement. But if the condition is met false, then it will stop running the loop and come outside, right? So let us understand how the graph work. We have first initialization. Remember, in for loop we have three elements. First it says please initialize the value. Once you initialize the variable with the value, then you check for the condition, and if condition is false, you come outside the loop and run the rest of the statement, or the loop is terminated. If the condition is true, then please execute these block of statements and then go to its updation. That updation may be an increment or decrement. So once the updation is made, again it goes back to the Boolean expression to check if the condition is true or false. Let us understand the flow diagram better with a practical example. So we have created here a class called test. Under the main method, we are trying to provide a for loop where we have initialized a value of a variable called x equals to 10, and then trying to check a condition if x is less than 20 or not, and then increment the value of x by 1. X plus plus is nothing but x plus 1, because x plus plus stands for incrementing by 1. You can change this 1 by 2 or 3 or any number that you would want to increment. Instead of incrementing, you may also want to decrement depending on the your value. Here we say x is equal to 10. Please check if x is less than 20. If it is not less than 20, it will come outside the loop and run the rest of the statements. If it is less than 20, first it will go execute these block of statement. These block of statement is nothing but where you are trying to print the value of x and then the next line. Once you execute the block of statement, only then it goes to the update statement. Therefore, update statements are not updated or incremented or decremented until unless you execute the block of statement. So now the value of x should be 11. If 11 is less than 20, and this process keeps repeating until unless the condition is true, and if it is false, it comes outside the loop. So let us now see how does this for loop works in practical.
We have created a class for for loop. Let us understand what is the syntax for loop and how it works. The class name is for loop, and we have created a main method in it, and then the syntax of for. How do we write the syntax of for? The keyword for, and then in the braces we need to pass three parameters, and the first one is nothing but the initialization. What is the value, what kind of a value it is, you need to initialize that. Second, what is the condition to be met on that particular value or the variable. Third, when should this condition be stopped? If you remember, in the while loop we had to provide the condition, otherwise the loop keep running infinitely. Then in the curly braces we write the block of statements that needs to be executed. So these statements are executed until it is true and then terminated. So here in this case we have created a variable called x which holds the value 10, and it keeps running or meeting the condition if x is less than or equal to 15. And if it is less than equal to 15, then please keep incrementing the value of x plus 1. And then print the value. So let us save and run this file to see the output. So it says that the value of x is 10. Yes, it is less than 15. So it has printed. Now the value of 10 would be 11. It goes back to the condition to check. Is 11 less than 15? Yes, again it will come and print 11, and so on. Then it goes and check if 14 is less than 15. Yes, it prints the value. Now, if 15 less than 15? No, but the condition says that if x is less than or equal to 15, that is, if 15 is less than or equal to 15. Yes, the condition is met. 15 is equal to 15. Therefore, it goes and print the value. But now x is holding the value as 16. Again, it comes back to check in the condition if 16 is less than or equal to 15. So is 16 less than 15? No. Is 16 equal to 15? No. Therefore, the condition is not met and the block of statements are not executed and the loop executes or terminates. The x plus plus is the incrementation, which can also be written as x equals to x plus 1. Let us save this and run. What should be the output? If you see, the output is the same because x plus plus can also be written as x equal to x plus 1.